That radio chick Cheryl Lee here. Welcome to the Still Rocking It podcast, where we'll have music, news reviews and interviews with some of our favourite Australian musicians and artists. Today's guest, lovingly known as Nollsy, is about to headline a national tour, which will see him perform at some of Australia's most prestigious live venues. Shannon Noll became one of Australia's most cherished and recognised artists when, on that unforgettable night at the Sydney Opera House, over 4 million people tuned in to watch the finale of the very first Australian Idol. 7 ARIA Top 10 albums, 17 platinum and 3 gold accreditations. His landmark single, What About Me, certified 4 times ARIA Platinum. The only Australian male artist in national ARIA chart history to have achieved 10 consecutive top 10 singles. Hope you enjoy the chat with Nollsy. To catch up on podcasts from other favourite artists, simply go to thatradiochick.com.au. Hi Shannon, how are you?
I'm very well, thanks.
That's good. They didn't tell me how long we have.
Yep, I've got another one in 15 minutes.
Jeepers, we better get stuck into it then.
Yeah, they're coming thick and fast these days.
I bet you probably flat chat, so thank you very much for your time. I'm going to do all the PR after then and just concentrate on chatting with you, if that's all right.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. No, that's fine, mate. Absolutely.
You're with Cheryl Lee, and I'd like to welcome into the studio today everybody's best mate, Shannon Noll. Thanks, Shannon.
G'day, Cheryl. How are you, hon?
Yeah, great to hear from you. Nice to chat. You've got some great celebrations going on at the moment, celebrating 20 years since the release of That's What I'm Talking About, with a special anniversary album and tour. But you also have another very important 20th anniversary as well, maybe more important.
Yeah, there's a lot happening at the moment, mate. So yeah, we're the release of the album and obviously a couple of new singles off there too. So we've got a new single coming up that Gary Frost actually wrote, who wrote What About Me. So that's really exciting. That's one part. Another single coming out with Cosima De Vito as well. Cosima and I got together after 20 years since the show. Obviously she came third or had to pull out of the show.
Yeah.
Controversially back in the day because she had nodules, so to get to work with her again was something really special, and she's done a great job on this song. So a couple of new releases as well.
Yes, but most importantly, are you not celebrating your 20th wedding anniversary this year?
Yes, they will be coming too. Absolutely.
Yeah, congratulations on that.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Yeah, time flies, that's for sure.
You are listening to Still Rocking It, the podcast with Cheryl Lee.
Before we go any further, I think we need to hear that new single. Here they are, Shannon Noll and Cosima De Vito, Don't You Want to Stay. It's a beautiful song. Back to find out where it all began. Chatting to Shannon Noll shortly. Don't you want to stay? We're going to go back a little bit before we go to current day and forward, if you don't mind. You grew up on the farm.
Yep.
Was music in your DNA? I know your brothers and you played in a band. Were either of your parents musical?
Yes, my dad and his family had a family band. Obviously, they grew up out in the bush. Mum actually grew up in Sydney, so she came from the Five Dock Glebe area. But Dad, they had a family band, so he was the drummer. My dad's brother was the guitarist, and their two sisters were keyboard player, and Auntie Judy played, I think they both might have played keys. So they played at just local dances and things like that back in the country area. So that was sort of where it all kicked off from.
So apart from farming, which is obviously was in the family, it sounds like that music was always there and always a passion. Was there any other plan B ever, or was it always going to be farming and music?
We grew up playing a lot of sport in the bush out there. A lot of times, you know, the only outlet you've got in small towns is sport opportunities. So there was a lot of sport played. We're sort of related to the Wall family. Dad's cousin's their mother. So
righto.
We sort of played a lot of cricket and a lot of golf, a lot of football. So my brother also trialled with the Sydney Swans and played Teal Cup for New South Wales AFL as well, which was a fair effort. And we grew up like 50 k's from the Danaher. So footy was a real big influence. I played football in Sydney. I moved down there when I was 19 and played a season in Sydney and then a season out in the Wagga Riverina League as well. So Aussie Rules was a big part of our life, as was cricket and that as well.
Oh, I can absolutely identify with that. Father of five, my hubby is from a farming family in rural Victoria. There wasn't really an option. You played footy in the winter, tennis in the summer. The girls played netball. Yeah, it definitely is a huge part of country communities.
Sport was always a little bit on the agenda as well. As it turned out, music was the one that's most solid.
The biggie.
If you know what I mean. So yeah. We don't have a farm anymore and we're too old for any sports. So I'm quite happy that music was the one that did shine through.
Still Rocking It podcast with that radio chick, Cheryl Lee. Nolsey is releasing a special 20th anniversary edition of his multi-platinum debut album, That's What I'm Talking About. The album will feature the original 12 recordings, including the hit singles What About Me, Drive and Learn to Fly, plus live recordings and two brand new songs. The album will be released both digitally and as a double CD package and, for the first time, released on vinyl. Let's have one of those hit singles now from the That's What I'm Talking About album. Learn to Fly reached number one on the Australian Singles Chart and received ARIA Gold certification, another beautiful song. And then back to speak some more to Nolsey. If you need to find a way back, feel you're on the wrong track, give it time. We forget sometimes, I think, that you've been so, so successful. 6 studio albums, 2 compilation albums, a video album, 28 singles of your own, yeah. Playing on singles with 7 others. Goodness gracious me. And you've certainly been busy.
Yeah.
Other than the music, because we're going to play some songs from some of the albums over the years.
Yep.
But apart from that, you opened with Bryan Adams in 2005 for his Aussie leg of his Room Service Tour.
Yeah, that was fantastic. He was such an amazing artist. And we went out and watched his show the first night, and just the amount of hits that has in his repertoire that he's written over the years. I mean, you remember the really big ones, but you sort of tend to forget a lot of the ones that were really, really fabulous songs as well, except they mightn't have been quite as big as the biggest ones that he's done. But once you watch his set, you find out that you know nearly every song. So
yeah.
That's an amazing thing. Yeah, that was an amazing tour.
You've got a few other feathers in your bow. 2007, your theatrical debut in the musical version of War of the Worlds.
Yeah, that was so much fun. I did the role of Parson and Nathaniel in the production, and then I was lucky enough they asked me to go on to a tour of Great Britain after that as well. So I ended up touring right through the UK with the show as well. We did two sold-out shows at the O2 Arena in London.
Wow.
With that tour. It was an amazing thing to be a part of. Just the size of the production was crazy. You know, I think there's something like 7 semi-trailers on the road with all the equipment and all the staging. It was an amazing thing. It was a cross between scripted verses from actors and whatnot that had passed away and were still sort of using their audio. So it was Richard Burton was the host of the show, so he's been gone a long time. So it was sort of an amazing thing to be a part of, but lots and lots of fun.
Yeah. You've also been honoured with an episode of This Is Your Life, which is pretty amazing for someone as young as you.
Yeah, I did wonder about that when they did it. But yeah, absolutely, that was a fabulous thing to be a part of as well. You know, I was a bit worried at the time. I thought they'd earmark me to retire or something along those lines. But as it turned out, no, it was just a bit of a recognition of the journey so far, which took me by surprise and a great thing to do as well. So it was a really good night.
Yeah, you should take it. It's a great compliment, and they'll probably have to do
absolutely
another one in another 20 years because part B.
Yeah, absolutely. The rest of the story.
That's right. Dancing with the Stars, you hurt your back pretty badly. How are you now with that spinal injury?
Yeah, no, well, a couple of years ago I ended up getting a spinal fusion, S1 vertebra down in the bottom lower tailbone area there. So we sort of got, and it's been pretty good since I've had that done. Now it's settled right down, so thankfully, because it was just, yeah, it was becoming impossible. Travel was the biggest thing which upset it the most. Obviously sitting in cars and being out on the road, and planes and cars and things like that. So it's settled down thankfully now, and And I'm back training at the gym, which is great, and it's pain-free for a change.
Excellent news. If you want to find out about Shannon's story so far, there's actually an autobiography already, which, again, I think you're going to have to do a part B later on, and it's called Shannon Noll So Far. And
yeah, no, we did. We had the book out. It was great. It was actually after I'd injured my back on Dancing with the Stars, so I was a bit laid up and couldn't really do much else after a laminectomy sort of small operation to take the pressure off the nerve initially. So it was a great opportunity to sit down and put pen to paper and sort of jot some of the story down. And yeah, it was a lot of fun doing the book for sure.
As I bet was 2018, I'm a celebrity. Get me out of here.
Yeah, that was a rip rise. That was hectic. That was. I often get asked if it's real, like they portray on the show, and yes, Solomon can say that it is. I lost 12 and a half kilos while I was in there, and it came out looking bone skinny. So it wasn't. It was a very, very hectic experience, but one I'll never forget. You know, being over in South Africa and going to the wildlife parks and being able to see the animals, you know, in their natural habitat, lions and tigers and rhinoceroses, and it was just an amazing experience, and one that I'll never forget. So I'm very, very thankful that I got the chance to go on that one.
You're everywhere, man. The Masked Singer as well, a couple of years ago.
Yeah, that was extra fun too. I was a bit hectic in the great big suit, though. I couldn't see much out of it, so I had to guess where the steps were and that on occasion. But yeah, that was a really fun one to be a part of as well, you know, and the crew and everybody was really fun to work with, so that was a lot of fun.
You are listening to Still Rocking It, the podcast with Cheryl Lee.
To celebrate the 20th anniversary of That's What I'm Talking About, the album, Shannon is also embarking on a That's What I'm Talking About tour pretty much all of April and all of May. For the Adelaideans, he is here at our Hindley Street Music Hall May 23rd. So I'll see you down the front there. Everyone else, get onto the Googleometer and see when Shannon is coming to a town near you. So I think it's time we played the single that started it all. His debut single, What About Me, certified 4 times platinum and became the highest selling single in Australia in 2004.
What about me? It isn't fair. I'm bad enough now. Oh, my share, can't you see?
I just wanted to also say thank you because, you know, I love it when our loved celebrities give back. And you have donated well over $1 million to various charities throughout Australia. So well done for that.
Thank you.
I love that you do that.
Yeah, thank you. I just believe you. After, you know, everything that the Australian public's given to me through support and through voting on the show, and like this, my whole career has been a gift from the Australian public through their support. So it's the least I can do to try and give a little bit back when the opportunity arises. So yeah, I'm glad to help.
You and your wife have 4 beautiful children.
Yep.
Are any of the kids musical, Shannon?
Yes, yeah, they are. The kids have got a bit of a family band up and running now. So, yeah, on our little property here, we've got a bit of a rehearsal studio that we've put together. So the kids are having a great time jamming in the shed, learning new songs, and they've done a couple of gigs on their own. So there's Blake plays guitar, the middle boy, and my brother's daughter and son play bass and drums. So it's a bit of a cousin band, but they're all Nolls in there. So they're enjoying some of the things that obviously we loved and enjoyed when we first started out. So it's a lot of fun just playing with the guys and jamming with the kids in the sheds, and sort of takes you back to them garage days when it was just a hobby and not a business. So it's a lot of fun to be able to revisit that again.
And absolute proof that it is in the family genes. Can I ask you, what does Shannon Noll like to listen to when you're alone, when you're like driving in the car or in the shower or wherever you listen to your music? What do you like to listen to, Shannon?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a bit of a Luke Combs fan at the moment. I've just been listening to him lately. I think he's, you know, an amazing talent and very, very amazing songwriter as well. So I've been sort of listening to him lately and getting into some of his songs. And yeah, he's an absolute legend, a really great songwriter and singer.
Any secret guilty pleasures? Is it Kylie or Taylor or something?
secret admiration.
Yeah.
And, that's a good one. He hasn't got a soft spot for Kylie, you know what I mean? She's just an Australian legend. So,
absolutely.
Definitely so proud of what she's achieved, and she just continues to achieve more and more. You definitely can't stop her. So all the best to Kylie, and congratulations on everything. She's an absolute marvel.
Yes, she is. You're both, Aussie legends through and through, that's for sure.
I don't know if I'm on her level at all. but it's something to strive to, for sure.
Still Rocking It podcast with that radio chick, Cheryl Lee. Shannon is such a modest artist, very down to earth considering all his awards and nominations. 2007, Lift won the most performed Australian work at the APRA Awards. The ARIA Chart Awards, 2004, that's what I'm talking about. Number one album, What About Me, number one single. Learn to Fly, number one single. A year later in 2005, Lift, number one album. Shine, number one single. Also at the Country Music Awards, 2016, Vocal Collaboration of the Year and Video Clip of the Year for Spirit of the Anzacs with Lee Kernaghan, Guy Sebastian, Jessica Mowboy, John Stevens, Shepherd and Megan Washington. MTV Music Awards, 2005, 2006, 2007, 3 years in a row for Best Male Artist. Even the Nickelodeon Australian Kids' Choice Awards, 2004. Shannon Noll, Favourite Australian. Drive, Favourite Song, 2007. Favourite Male Singer. I'd like to play for you now, Spirit of the Anzacs, and then back to say goodbye to Shannon.
He's a drover drifting over Western Plains. He's a city lad, a clock down Flinders Lane.
I know that you've got us lined up today. You're a popular man at the moment with a new album coming out, a new tour coming up, and a brand new single. And I really appreciate you spending the time with us today. Thank you.
Oh, good on you, Cheryl. Thank you so much. And I'm really looking forward to getting back over there. So it'll be a lot of fun.
Yep, we'll see you down the front. I think you're at our Piney Street Music Hall soon. I'll let you get back to it.
Great, hon. Thank you so much. Great chatting to you.
Righto. Well, Shannon, 14 minutes and 30 seconds. So there I hope I've go. Kept you Brilliant. On schedule.
Brilliant. Yeah, you sure have. Thank you so much.
All righty. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Thanks, I'll see you.
Righto, ta-da.
Bye-bye.
Bye. You are listening to Still Rocking It, the podcast with Cheryl Lee.
Shannon Noll's everyman appeal lies in his honesty and instant relatability. His rise to fame as the runner-up of the record-breaking first series of Australian Idol saw him go from being a farmhand in Condobolin to one of Australia's most cherished and recognised recording artists and entertainers. Let's hear a little snippet from what judges Mark Holden, Marsha Hines and Ian Dicko Dixon had to say, and then we're going to go out with Shannon's beautiful version of Southern Sun's Hold Me In Your Arms, his audition song. And remember, there's no music, there's no instruments, there's no backing vocals. It's just Shannon doing what he does best and singing.
Wow, and you just won me 100%.
Oh, beauty.
You won me 100%, man.
Thank you.
Thank you for that.
Thank you. So
good on you.
Beauty.
Marsha. Big yes for me.
Thank you.
Just
it's such a wonderful thing still to discover a voice.
Yeah.
And we have just discovered a voice.
Yeah.
And I'm so happy that we can do this for you.
I think you've got an absolute joy inside you. And you let it out through in that song, and it was fabulous to watch for me.
Thank you.
You know?
So hold me in your arms. Hold me in your arms.
You're with Cheryl Lee, that radio chick. Thank you so much for joining me on the Still Rocking It podcast. Hope to catch you again next time. Get out when you can, support Aussie music, and I'll see you down the front.